Let's turn to Huffington Post senior political editor, MSNBC political analyst Howard Fineman. Good evening, Howard.
Hi, Keith.
Am I mistaken? Was the president startled today that he was getting blowback for this rather than a round of applause from the planet?
Well, I think he was, because originally they weren't scheduling a press conference. Then they decided things were going on so much all over town, they had to get the president out there to try to take control of it. I just came from the White House Christmas party, and everybody's having a nice, quiet time in there. Meanwhile, a couple miles down the road on Pennsylvania Avenue, the House Democrats have been caucusing again. And what I hear is that they're practically, you know, throwing chairs against the wall. They're so upset. And it's not just the, quote, progressives or, quote, liberals that are upset. The president with this bill, because the tax cuts that Ezra was talking about are, quote, not funded, meaning there are no compensatory spending cuts anywhere, a lot of the blue dogs, ironically, the conservative Democrats who are worried about deficits, are also claiming that they're upset about this. So it's a really interesting and dangerous dynamic for the president right now, even while he's shaking hands with all the press people behind me.
Can he pass it? And what happens to him politically if he can't pass this?
Well, can he pass it? Yes. But is it going to be more difficult than they thought? Yes. I wrote a piece for HuffPost on Sunday speculating about this, but it's really gotten a lot farther out of the White House's control than I thought possible and my sources thought possible on Sunday. It's still likely, I would have to say better than 50-50, that it'll pass, because what's going to happen is the Democratic leaders in the House and the Senate are going to let as many people as possible vote no as long as they have just enough votes to pass it. That was their strategy going in, but whether they'll be able to hold the line is going to depend in part, I'm told, on whether other sweeteners can be put in there for Democrats. And so this isn't over by any means. The House Democratic Caucus is going to request more, and I'm told that the Senate Caucus, which is going to meet again tomorrow, is also going to request further items in this thing to try to smooth the way for Democrats to vote for it.
The president said he did not want to play politics with this. To what degree is his political imperative to win back independent voters, though, responsible for this deal, as the Washington Post suggested today?
Well, I think it's possible. It's not only possible, it's true that there are two things. Getting back independent voters by showing he can get things done and deal with Republicans, which, after all, is what a lot of independents want, and shift the economic theory away from big government programs, whether it's the health care program or the stimulus or whatever, to tax cuts. And the irony here is that the president is sort of channeling Ronald Reagan in an effort to not become Jimmy Carter. Yes, they're all tax cuts, and as Ezra said, there are a lot of progressive tax cuts. But the point is, the president is validating the idea of tax cuts as the centerpiece of economic policy, and that's something that the Republicans are best at. So he's fighting on their turf, but he has no choice, he thinks, but to do it right now. But that's why everybody's upset with him.
Is anybody in that building behind you worried that he was yelling at liberals and progressives and Democrats and has not been seen to be yelling at conservatives and Republicans?
Yeah, the spirit in there was, you don't ask, you just wish each other, you know, nice holidays and Merry Christmas. But sure, they have to be worried about it, because a lot of his anger today was about that. He said, you don't appreciate what I've been doing. You don't appreciate the health care bill, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. You know, I passed this, I passed that. There's a certain element of personal pique involved, which is never good for a president to display in public.
Only about 138%. Right. Howard Fineman, senior political editor of the Huffington Post, on a cold night outside of the White House. Go back inside, say hello to everybody for me, although they probably won't want to hear from me. Thanks,
yeah,
Howard.
Sure they do.
Okay, no, fine. Not after tonight they won't. Thanks.